Hello, I am Dr. Isam Al-Amin from the Department of Obstetric and Gynecology, Faculty of Medicine. First, I would like to welcome all students in fifth year and those who joined this course, OB1. And my strong wishes to have enjoyment during this module and finally get a great success. In this lecture or in this talk, I am going to speak about preconceptional counseling or preconceptional care. Outline and this lecture, I am going to talk about first definition of preconceptional care. I will explain also the goals of the preconceptional care. And what are the components and what is the benefits? What are the benefits of preconceptional care? Finally, I will give you some example of preconceptional care. First, what is the definition of preconception care? BCC. Preconceptional care, really it is interventions. It is intervention including prevention and management. The aim of this is to treat or to manage all the risk that affect women's health or affect pregnancy outcomes. It is a set of prevention and management interventions that aim to identify and modify biomedical, behavioral, and social risk to women health or pregnancy outcome. This is CDC June 2005. This means that preconception care means group of prevention and management or treatment that will modify or treat the risk. What are these risks? Either behavioral, social, that can affect the woman health or the pregnancy outcome. What is the goals? What are the goals? What are the aims of preconceptional care? First, optimize woman health. We have to adjust or to treat or to manage the condition of the women. Also, minimize risk to her and her fetus. We have or we should minimize as less as possible the risk to the mother or her fetus. Improve, one of the most important goals is to improve pregnancy outcome. Another goal or aim is to provide information necessary to make informed decision when we are going to decide about the health of a woman during pregnancy or during labor. We have to give her information that can enable her to take a good decision for her and for her fetus, and also have to decide about her future pregnancy. Why we are using preconception care? Why? We know the aims. Then we want to know why preconception care. As you know, most of women came to antenatal care too late. Some of them came at 4 months, some of them came off 6 months, and even some of women comes at labor or delivery without any care, without antenatal care. And as you know, there is many risk affecting women in the first months and the critical period for this. Most of congenital anomalies and for teratogenesis occur during days from 17 to 56. This is very critical period. Even sometimes the women does not know whether she is pregnant or not during this period. So preconception care is very important so as to prevent this defect. If you care about the woman from the start of before pregnancy, you know how to prevent of how to remove the risk during this period, early pregnancy. As you know, usually heart rate begins at 22 days, neural tube closes by 28 days. The plate or the palate also views it as 56 days. All these organogenesis occur in a very critical period in early pregnancy. And so we want to prevent this teratogenesis and this effect early, and this is the aim, and this is let that preconception occur is very important. Also, we want to prevent implantation error, which can lead to ectopic pregnancy, can lead to abortion, can lead to many risk to the mother. Here, this is this picture. It will show you the critical period where the organ of the fetus develop as early as possible, 5 days, 6 days, 7 days, like this. And this led that preconception care is important. As you know, here central nervous system and heart and arms, all this occur and develop in very, very early life of the fetus. Need of preconceptional care, BCC, currently. Now, as you know, as I told, as I explained in this previous slide, that most of women attend the antenatal care late, so the critical period can face some problem, teratogenesis, any things. And currently, as I told, poor pregnancy outcome. Because of this reason, we have many poor pregnancies. Because women come with risk, and so we intervene late, our intervention late. After the woman came and we found that there is congenital anomaly, there is some preventive condition, and there is a census. All the scientists and all doctors and all societies agree that, all of them agree that we must act before pregnancy. So this is the importance of preconceptional care. We need to intervene, or intervention should be done before pregnancy, so as we improve our pregnancy outcome. Here is a paradigm shift. We need to, from anticipation and management, waiting, anticipating what will happen, and then after the risk occurs, then we management. No, we need to change this to health promotion and prevention. We need to prevent the risk from early, to prevent any condition to occur. Also, we want to change our also paradigm from healthy mother, healthy babies to healthy women. We need to treat the women, to manage the women before pregnancy, to adjust her condition and to adjust her condition. What are the components of preconceptional care? How we will achieve that? How we achieve this goal and how we achieve this aims? First, we should do risk assessment. First, we have to assess the mother and assess her condition. Then we intervene with intervention to promote her health, and we will intervene after that. We do many interventions so as to prevent all these risks. Let us speak about risk assessment. Risk assessment starts from reproductive plan. Ask the mother about her reproductive plan to know what her problem is, the spacing of pregnancy, how she want how to get pregnant, her the medical condition, is it optimized, is it suitable for her to get pregnant. Then after that, we will take history from the women, know about her pregnancy, about her medical condition, about also we should do a physical examination and to know about her. Also, screening is very important, screening about disease. Let us go in details about history taking. We should ask about reproductive history, previous adverse outcome, if any previous adverse outcome, infant death, fetal loss, birth defect, low birth weight, preterm labor, all these can recur in current pregnancy. So we need to ask about reproductive history. Another important point is medical history about rheumatic heart disease. We should ask about thromboembolism, about autoimmune disease, about hypertension and diabetes. All these need intervention. We have to know whether she is diabetic, whether she is hypertensive. Is she need any adjustment, for any optimization for her condition? Also, we should know about medication. What type of medication? Because sometimes medication can affect pregnancy, can affect the fetus. Some drugs are teratogenic. So we need to know what current medications you are using now. All this from history, you can eliminate from history. We need to avoid some medication during pregnancy, like estrogen, thalidomide. And also some medication like category D, we need to avoid, unless the benefit outweighs fetal risk. Some drugs like over-the-counter medication, and some herbs and some other supplement also need to be, we want to know about it. This is dangerous during pregnancy and during early pregnancy, during teratogenesis. Also, in history, we should inquire about substance abuse, about tobacco, about alcohol, about drugs. All these are very dangerous in early pregnancy. After we take a thorough history and ask about all this history and to know the important point in her history, then we go to next step about examination. We should examine the woman, examine the mother. We will assess a nutritional assessment. How? Assess the ABCD of nutrition. Anthropometric factor like BMI. We should measure the woman, her length, her weight, and calculate her BMI. Is it suitable for her to get pregnant? Is she obese? And we should tell her about obesity and the risk of obesity. Also, we should ask about a biochemical factor like anemia. Check for her blood for anemia, hemoglobin. Other clinical factors like dietary risk, also we ask about dietary risk. Focus on periodontal, thyroid, and heart. All these breast pelvic examination, we should examine all this. Thyroid, we should examine heart, we should examine breast, we should examine also do pelvic examination to elicit any abnormalities. After we finish history and finish examination, we should go to investigation. We should screen the mother. Screen about what? Screen about infection immunization. Screen for periodontal, urogenital, sexually transmitted disease as indicated. All this should be screened about. Also, update immunization. We should ask a woman about her immunization. She needs any vaccination, we should complete it. Suppose that hepatitis B, suppose that rubella, varicella, human papilloma virus, and influenza vaccine as needed. So, also we should ask about genetic screening. As you know, some disease, if the husband is carrier and the mother is carrier, the discipline or the children will be affected. So we need to screen about this genetic, about like anemia, like other disease, Down syndrome, many diseases need screening. And based on family history, this can be known by family history. Ask about sickle cell disease, sickle cell anemia, about that in the family, in the husband, and so on. So, offer also cystic fibrosis. Cystic fibrosis also, these need to some screening, other carrier screening as indicated. We need to know about this serious disease. If the mother is carrier and the husband is carrier, we need to intervene, to make some intervention and to advise for how to manage that. Also, we need to psychosocial. You know, some of this psychological problem and these are very dangerous during pregnancy, even can lead to suicide. So we screen for depression. Postpartum depression is increased after pregnancy, after delivery. So we need to ask about screen for or ask about depression, or ask for anxiety, ask for domestic violence. If the mother and husband are always in abuse, the husband abuse the mother, and there is a domestic violence, we need to know about that because the children will be in danger. After that, we need to do laboratory testing. So we need about CBC to know whether the patient is anemic or not. Urine analysis, we ask about blood type, what type of group, blood groups. As you know, this isoimmunization, ABOR is negative. So we need to know about that. If indicated, also we need to screen about rubella and about syphilis, hepatitis, human HIV, AIDS, AIDS and hepatitis B. Also gonorrhea, diabetes, chlamydia. We should screen about these dangerous diseases so as to manage women and to optimize her condition and to manage her accordingly. If you found any risk, then we will manage accordingly. The second component of preconception care is health promotion. How to promote health, how to improve the woman's health by first family planning. We need to introduce or to ask women to use emergency contraception. Why? Because we need to prevent unintended pregnancy. Some women got unintended pregnancy. This is a very high risk pregnancy. Suppose that the woman is diabetic or her condition not permit her to get pregnant. So we need to use contraceptive, emergency contraceptive to prevent unintended, unwanted pregnancy. Effective contraceptive use as the reproductive plan. We want to know her reproductive plan first component. When she want to get pregnant, when she stop her contraception, when. Suppose that mother is diabetic. We need to optimize her condition and to adjust her blood sugar and to adjust her hemoglobin A1C. After she become optimized and her condition become medically okay, then we will ask her to stop contraception and to get pregnant. So effective contraception is very important. Healthy weight and nutrition. We need the mother to be healthy, her weight, if she is obese, to improve, to become during normal limits. Ask her to nutrition, to improve her nutrition. A nutritionist, advise her to talk to a nutritionist. Ideal BMI, as you know, is 20 from 26 kg per meter squared. So we ask about exercise. Ask woman or advise the woman to do exercise and to improve nutrition, to good healthy diet. And we supply some women, those who are planning to get pregnant, with daily folic acid and vitamin B12. Before pregnancy, this is before pregnancy, you promote her health before pregnancy. Also, we should talk about healthy behavior, like nutrition, exercise, safe sex, discourage risky behavior. Some that affect her mother, affect the mother, affect the baby, like touching, not wearing seat belt, smoking, stop smoking. Also ask about healthy environment. Exposure to heavy metal like asbestos, like organic solvent, like pesticides, those who are working in farm, and those who are doing with insecticides, and those who are working in farmers, husband of farmer, and some women are working in factories. Asbestos are like this, we should know that and manage accordingly. What are the intervention? The fifth component, what are the intervention? If we discover any risk or if we discover any problem, so we should intervene so as to prevent any risk to happen. And we will improve the pregnancy outcome. One of these intervention is folic acid supplementation. As you know, this neural tube defect, it reduced when you are using folic acid, reduced by 2 cells. Rubella vaccination, we need to vaccinate women so as to protect against congenital rubella. As you know, rubella is very dangerous to the fetus. Hepatitis B vaccination, we need hepatitis B because for those who are at risk, women who are at risk, suppose that mother, she is working in somewhere and at risk, her husband, for example, is hepatitis or so and so, we need to vaccinate her. Diabetes management, those who are diabetic, we need to reduce base defect and those of infant diabetic women, say some congenital anomalies, those who are large size baby, there is some birth defect and during labor and delivery they face birth asphyxia and shoulder dystocia because of size baby. So we need to optimize her condition and to regulate her blood sugar. Those who are with hypothyroidism, what we will do for them? We should, with multidisciplinary with other endocrinologists, we need to talk to an endocrinologist and to adjust and optimize her condition, and after that she can get pregnant. Those with AIDS, HIV and AIDS screening, we should do screening for her. So we need to manage that accordingly. If the mother is HIV or she has AIDS disease, we need to give her treatment and we need to vaccinate the infant. So to decrease the mother-baby transmission of AIDS, which is very important. Smoking cessation, those who are smoker, mother who are smoker, we need to ask them to stop smoking. Eliminating alcohol use, obesity control by exercise, by diet, by nutrition, and also switching from oral anticoagulant to heparin. Some medications are very dangerous and very dangerous to the mother for congenital anomalies, for teratogenic. So we need to stop them or to modify them, anti-epileptic drugs. Also, we need to change to less teratogenic drugs. With realization with multidisciplinary and those doctor who is in concern. What are the benefits of preconceptional care? As I told before, we have aims and we need to goals. The benefits of preconceptional care, as we told that, we can reduce unintended pregnancy. From the start, we can use this, as I told before, we can use contraception. So as an unintended pregnancy or unwanted pregnancy will not happen. If a mother is diabetic and her sugar is not adjusted, hemoglobin A1C is high, so to get pregnant is very risky for her and risky for the fetus. So we prevent pregnancy in this condition by using contraceptive method. So we reduce and stop or prevent unintended pregnancy or unsuitable pregnancy. Also, we can prevent birth defect. One of the benefits of preconceptional counseling, with some condition, we prevent birth defect by stopping these teratogenic drugs and so on, so or modify some warfarin to heparin like that. This we can prevent birth defect. Also, we can prevent low birth weight and prematurity. Prevent poor pregnancy outcomes and recurrence of preterm labor, recurrence of like that, and promote healthy behavior and reduce risk taking behavior. Prepares and reinforces parent for parenting. This is very important point. Those who are young couples and those who are married early, they need to know how to treat their children, how to manage, how to come father, how to come mother. This need preconceptional care before pregnancy. And all this can also by promote family planning. We need to do a good spacing. Those who are at risk, they need to make spacing between children for breastfeeding, for their own health, for the health of the baby. Here in this, at the end of this lecture, or at this slide, coming slide, I will show you some condition and what are the types of recommendation for preconceptional counseling. Please go through these tables. This from William, page 182. Condition, suppose environmental exposure, abnormal weight, these are condition. Abnormal weight, we need to calculate BMI yearly. So as BMI less or more than 25 kg meter square, counsel about death. Cardiovascular disease, some measure, we are doing some measure here, chronic hypertension, asthma, thrombophilia, renal disease. And another condition also, hematological disease, diabetes. Suppose that for diabetes, what are the recommendations? Recommendation for diabetes, optimize glycemic control, minimize teratogenicity of hyperglycemia, evaluate for end organ damage such as retinopathy, nephropathy, hypertension. This is one of the most important preconceptional care. Thyroid disease, connective tissue disease, infectious disease, sexually transmitted disease, hematological diseases, also thyroid, all these recommendations for preconceptional care. By the end of this slide, I come to my to finish my talk about preconceptional care, and I would like again to thank you all for attending and for good listening, and thank you very much. Thank you very much, and see you in the next lecture. Thank you. Goodbye.